The percentage of men with spinal cord injury who can successfully ejaculate is low. In this video, two clinicians from the Sexual Health and Rehabilitation Clinic in Vancouver provide an overview of penile vibratory stimulation, or PVS, including procedures and some cautions.
One of the things we do is penile vibratory stimulation, or PVS, and there's two reasons that we do that. The first is to see whether or not we can induce ejaculation in men that have trouble ejaculating, which is usually the case after spinal cord injury.
It's a method of sperm retrieval. So if someone's interested in becoming a biological parent, for example.
And the second reason is to figure out if ejaculation could potentially cause some sort of, you know, pleasurable sensation or orgasm.
Ejaculation, if you think about it as a body's reflex to stimulation, whereas orgasm is that intense pleasurable release that people get with sexual climax, and it's largely in the brain. In other words, if you have ejaculation, it doesn't necessarily mean you have orgasm, and vice versa.
I did an interview with Dr. Jenna Dipp, who's a GP, on how to use the vibrator on a penile model.
In vibrostimulation, there's often a signature spot. So when you practice this, you'll find that, you know, some men say, no, it's right here or it's right there. Mm-hmm. If you are able to hold your own vibrator, you just listen to your body signs, you know, of your breathing changing, of the abdomen tight. You start to listen, and by placement, even if you can't feel it, by placement, you'll start to recognize that the spasm's starting to build up, and then it might actually kind of turn kind of clonic. The testes actually come up, the scrotum actually lifts up, and the glands of the penis, even if you've lost your erection, the glands of the penis will swell. And those are premonitory signs that ejaculation is going to happen. Some men, they just place, say, a Ferticare, and they just leave it there, and it'll actually trigger it. But I'm finding that the more that you learn sort of the skill of what works for you to help you ejaculate, the faster you'll ejaculate. And that might not sound very sexy, but the faster you ejaculate, the less chance your blood pressure is going to be bad.
To be able to ejaculate after spinal cord injury, you need that high frequency and high amplitude, which is not something that you can get from your partner in regular sexual activity. That's why it's so difficult to ejaculate with regular sexual activity. This is the Ferticare 2. This is the new device in the videos that you've seen before. It was the older model. This is the new model. And this is the one that you can buy now. Before, we used to be able to bump it and turn it on, but now we need to turn it on like this. What's really important in the vibrators is the amplitude of this little vibrating piece needs to be at least 2 millimeters. So this is a specialty vibrator built for men with spinal cord injury. We can adjust it to what type of hertz and what type of amplitude. And we usually have it about 3.5. So this is a very specialized one. It's expensive, but it's very good, and the battery lasts a long time. Something like this is a wall vibrator. The key to this is that it has a pretty strong vibration, and that there's a bell shape. That's where the glands of the penis would go. And that seems to give more stimulation than like a little buzzy vibrator that you would get in a sex shop. If you have limited hand function, you could use something like a snake clamp that's developed, then you can just put the vibrator inside, and your OT or your PT, your occupational therapy department, would be able to help you get this. And that allows you to use the vibrator hands-free.
Ordinarily, with orgasm, ejaculation, you can see an increase in blood pressure. However, we like to see it within a safe range. An individual with T6 level and above, their baseline systolic is usually in the range between 90 and 110 of millimeters of mercury. If you see a blood pressure rise of 20 to 40 above that baseline, that would be considered autonomic dysreflexia.
Typically, when you get autonomic dysreflexia, you will feel some symptoms. You might get a headache, you might get some sweating, you might get some goosebumps on your arms. Some people feel like something bad is going to happen to them.
It's important to note that sometimes you get this increase in blood pressure without any signs and symptoms other than the increase in blood pressure itself, and we call this silent AD.
which is actually just the same risk as if you had symptoms.
If you do experience AD,
then you need to stop the stimulation.
Sit up to 90 degrees and lower your legs if that's possible. Keep monitoring the blood pressure every 1 to 2 minutes to make sure your symptoms are stabilizing. You may want to check if you have any constrictive clothing or bedding, or sometimes kinks in the catheter tubing, or actually any other typical cause for AD, which is could be a full bladder, full bowel, could be a pressure area. If 5 minutes goes by and your blood pressure still hasn't come down, you may want to consider fast-acting, short-duration blood pressure medication, such as nifedipine or sublingual clonidine. This is something you can talk to your spinal cord injury care provider about. If after 5 minutes you've taken the medication and nothing's happening, your blood pressure's still high, go to eMERGE.
It's been my experience that some men over time feel less symptoms the more they ejaculate. And it's kind of like, well, I guess maybe I'm not so dysreflexic anymore, but that's not necessarily true. So just be careful that hopefully your symptoms will diminish with time the more that you do vibrostimulation, but to always be aware that your pressure still may be at a risk. We really encourage you to be sexually active. We encourage you to do all these things, but just be careful that it doesn't go too high.
There are some strategies to use to try and prevent AD when you're doing PVS at home, in the home setting.
And before you even start the PVS, you might want to be sure that your bladder and bowel are empty.
Position yourself sitting up if that's possible. You want to use the on-off technique that we teach people in the clinic setting.
Apply the vibrator for short intervals, so you don't keep it on for minutes and minutes, maybe 1 to 2 minutes maximum.
You want to make sure you monitor blood pressure before, during, and after the PVS. You want to keep in mind that you could take medication ahead of time if you're prone to autonomic dysreflexia.
We have a specialized clinic in Vancouver, BC, but there's not many clinics like ours around. So try to go to a healthcare provider that has some information or good websites that have some information.
One example is our website, scisexualhealth.ca, which we created in partnership with Spinal Cord Injury BC, including persons with lived experience of spinal cord injury.
If you're interested in coming to Vancouver for our sexual health rehab service, here's the information on that.
Speak with one of the clinicians prior to trialing PVS at home.
I do want to encourage you to enjoy your sexual life. There's lots of potential, but I'd like you to do it safely.